Defenders, and welcome back to my channel. I know you have a lot of choices when it comes to flying the YouTubes, guys, so we're super grateful that you're here flying with us. My name is Sasha, and I'll be assisting you through today's journey. We'll be coming down the aisle shortly with our last service, week 8 of the Otaku Ramen Summer Series, the King of Monsters Bowl. I can't believe we've had 2 months of ramen. I mean, I can't believe it. I love ramen. It's fantastic, but I'm kind of sad that it's coming to an end. If you're just joining us for the first time, this is an 8-part series where we talk about the different weekly bowls in the Otaku Ramen Summer Series, which is an annual series that creates themed dishes based on, well, a theme. This year's theme is kaiju, or giant Japanese movie monsters that aren't typically scary but can be. Godzilla is the best example, and here we are. I can only assume the bowl is Godzilla because of the imagery and the name. But yeah, the video is going to look a little bit like this. I'll tell you a little bit about the kaiju, I'll tell you a little bit about the bowl, and then we'll try it. It's a good time. Let's get started. Godzilla, or the King of Monsters, first appeared in 1954 in a self-titled debut from the creative mind of Ishiho Honda. He burst into popularity, everyone loves him, and he's been in 32 films since then, which is wild. That's a lot of movies for something that's not real. I always thought Godzilla was a dinosaur, but it turns out he's a prehistoric sea creature, so I learned something new today. I hope you did too. Godzilla the sea creature is the way that he is thanks to nuclear radiation. There are a lot of theories that Godzilla is kind of like a metaphor for nuclear weaponry in and of itself, just because it was so close to the Hiroshima bombings and the Lucky Dragon 5 incident. So apparently America was testing in an ocean, and there was a fishing boat out there, and the individuals that were sailing ended up getting acute radiation syndrome from it, which is super bad. Acute be darned, which is super bad. So they were treating them with blood transfusions, and they inadvertently infected all of them with hepatitis as well. So it was like a really bad situation. Godzilla might not have existed if it wasn't for nuclear fallout, and he exists. So maybe that's the bad part of it. Godzilla's also just been seen as kind of like a reminder that, you know, humans might not always be the coolest thing on the block. So yeah. A lot of themes here. He is a giant monster. There's room here for interpretation. When Godzilla first arrived to America in 1955, the director made an interesting choice and tried to rename Godzilla to Gigantus, and people were like, we know what you're doing here. Godzilla's size actually varies film to film, which is very interesting, and he's been depicted as anywhere from 164 feet to almost 1,000 feet tall. The need for this stemmed from several things, including needing to redo miniature sets to make the movie happen, but also that Tokyo over the decades got taller and taller skylines, so they needed a scarier and scarier monster. So, yeah. Godzilla's signature move is the atomic heat beam, which I'm into. Godzilla's kind of molded movie to movie to be what the theme needs. So sometimes he's a good guy, sometimes he's a bad guy, sometimes he fights along humans, and sometimes he destroys them. Godzilla only appeared in CGI for the first time in 2014. So that's a fun one for you. All in all, it's impossible not to be enraptured by the creature that is Godzilla. He stomps and roars into all of our hearts. He or she, or it. And I really appreciate the monster more than I think I ever had throughout this whole series, so. Overall, I've really enjoyed researching all of these kaiju, Godzilla especially, my new favorite. The bowl this week. It is delightfully complex and simple at the same time. We're looking at a beef, pork, and chicken broth. That's a tall order. I have no doubt it's gonna be amazing. I'm imagining some very rich, heavy flavors. It's also topped with sirloin. Steak is not my favorite, and this is no one else's fault, but I'm not as excited as I could be for steak. Most people are more excited, but you know, it's fine. I like shaved beef. I don't know. Don't judge me. It's not my thing. It also has bean sprouts and cabbage though, and I'm very excited, as well as a miso butter. Oh, a garlic butter. And I'm so excited because this style of ramen really reminds me of a fun experience that we had in Japan. Jiro and I had just gotten off the plane. I was struggling to keep him awake a little bit longer to fight the jet lag, so I was like, let's go have ramen. We were staying kind of outside of the city because we were leaving for Kyoto the next day. And we find this teeny tiny ramen shop. There is only a vending machine. There is no English. So we're pushing buttons and putting money into the machine. And we finally get up to the counter and we hand in our tickets. And we spoke zero Japanese at the time. Well, just not enough for sure. But they ended up serving us like this bowl of ramen. Imagine with me. Bowl of ramen. I believe it was a pork broth. It had the chashu, the egg, but there were bean sprouts literally served in a mountain on top. So it was super fun for me. Jeremiah didn't want to be rude, so he like snuck and hid the bean sprouts like in my bowl. But it was a delicious bowl of ramen, and it felt so natural to just like poke in, eat ramen, and leave, and not have to worry about tourists or anything like that. It was pretty late at night. It was a wonderful, wonderful experience. So this gyokotsu ramen is actually being served Jiro-style, and so I did a couple of minutes of research into what that could mean, and apparently there was a Jiro ramen shop, there still is, in Kyoto that serves kind of like an over-the-top imagining of ramen. The noodles are very thick, the broth is very distinct and unique, which typically means multiple meats mixed together. And apparently the toppings are like very thick, like sliced thick like steak, it says, and the garlic flavor is very well present. So I think that is the style of ramen that we're going for, and it sounds very much like the style of ramen that Jeremiah and I had. Let's go try the bowl. It looks like I'm in heaven, because I am.
Marshmallow.
Hi.
Ripley, stop. You're incognito, just trying to get a look at
the. Yeah, he is.
Come here.
It's Godzilla. It almost spilled it everywhere. Caveat, I took all of Jeremiah's bean sprouts and cabbages, so this is more than you normally get in your bowl. Let's give it a taste. First of all, steak on a ramen. It's steak on a ramen. I want to be excited, but I can't. It's good. Look at that. Bingo bango. Let's see how long that lasts. Oh my God, the broth is incredible. I couldn't tell if Josh was praying or not.
I'm just trying to miss the Miyagi fly over here. No,
cool. Oh man, this is a good bowl. This feels like the culture. Which was a TikTok reference. Sorry about that. Yeah. It's crunchy, it's creamy, it's fatty. It's got steak on it. This broth is three animals in one. I'm very into it. But I'm gonna eat it with my friends instead of talking to a camera. Thank you for watching. Trying that ramen with me, especially outside with the foggy lens. I appreciate your patience. It was such a good time to see our friends and share that experience with them. If you liked this video, give it a like. I will see you next year for I hope an 8-week series of ramen, and subscribe if you haven't already. Thanks for watching again. Bye-bye.